Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make these beautiful candles for the upcoming season. Unfortunately, I can't turn all the lights off for you to see how they look, but I hope you have an idea just from seeing them like this. So, without further ado, let's get into this. Let me start by saying that this is not my original creation. This is a version of the ones that Josie from Life at 50 and Beyond made a couple of weeks ago, and I love them. I encourage you to visit her channel because you have no idea how creative she is and the awesome things she makes every week for all of us to get inspired. I'm using the flameless candles from Dollar Tree. You know them already. And I use vellum paper, the regular vellum paper, regular size, letter size. And I printed the images from internet this way. There is a piece of paper that is not here anymore because I have already cut the image. But for you to be able to cover the whole circumference of the candle, you have to print the image this way. Then I cut every image. Let me show you all the other things that I cut. This one is really, really vintage. I really like it. This is like the night before Christmas Eve. Only Santa is missing here. I love birch wood, so I printed one image with birch wood and another image with birch wood because I plan to use two candles with birch wood image on them in the same arrangement. Then, once I had this paper, because in these ones I have already cut the borders. What I did was first I took another candle, and I'm going to show you what I did for the border. I just placed whatever part you want here, and I went on rotating the candle. To get the whole border marked in this piece of scrap. Then I cut all the border, and this is a piece I got. As you can see, now I have a piece to use to mark my images and cut them before adhering them to the candle. So I place this here, I trace the border, like so. And then I just have to, oh my god, sorry about that, the flying scissors. So I just have to cut the border around the mark I made. Like this. And I have it ready to be applied to the candle. You have to look for the matching parts. And that's mainly it. You see? Again, you can add some adhesive and you can fix, adhere the image directly to the candle on, or just place a little bit of scotch tape here and then you can reuse the candle. But the effect is so beautiful. I'm sorry you can't see it really, but believe me, it's beautiful. I'm going to show you. I'm going to turn all the lights off for a last scene so you will be able to see how they really look. So let me show you. Well, now you can see how they look. Aren't they absolutely gorgeous? I love them. I really love them. Thank you, Josie, for the inspiration. The link is going to be below for you to be able to visit her channel and get inspired. And okay, I hope you like this idea. Maybe you will be able to come out with other versions and personalize them according to your style. So if you really liked it, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you are not a subscriber already. As usual, thank you so much for watching and hope to see you in my next video. Take care. Bye bye.